Hello guys, NeapleTimes here, welcome to a new video, and today I'm gonna show you how you can change your default mail and browser app in iOS and iPadOS. Okay, so a couple years ago, I'm pretty sure it was iOS 14 or 15, Apple gave us the option to change the default browser app and mail app on iOS. This has, of course, been in response to a lot of anti-monopoly trials that Apple is facing all around the world. However, yeah, many users were asking for it and they finally gave us the option. So yeah, enough of me talking, I'll show you. Okay, so as you will see, this is a very simple process. The first thing you need to do, of course, is make sure that you have the app that you want to make default installed. So in this case, I will have Chrome here and I have Gmail here. So that's very important. Then we need to jump into settings. And in settings, we need to scroll all the way down past all the default app setting until the custom app settings, and then find here the app that we want to make default. So for example, Chrome is here and Gmail will be further down. But if I type Chrome, for example, you will see how you get the option to choose your default browser app. So in this case, I have Safari as default, but I can change it to Chrome. And of course, if I had more browsers installed, I would get that option too. Similarly, if we scroll further down until we see Gmail, which is here, I just tap it and I see default mail app. So I have mail, but I can set it to Gmail. And now you will see that if I open any link, for example, this one's from Amazon, it will open in Chrome. And that is how you set your default browser and mail app. So yeah, very quick video. So let's go ahead and finish it. Okay, so as you saw, this is very simple. The only thing is that it's hidden within the app settings. So yeah, that's kind of eh. It should be like in Safari or browser settings or whatever, but it is not. But yeah, that's it. You only have to do it once and it will be done. Now, I didn't show it in the video, but of course the process is the same in iPadOS. You would of course have to jump in the settings and that's it. But yeah, if you have any questions about this process, please let me know down below in the comments and I will do my best to answer. Also, if you like this video, please thumbs up. And if you found it helpful and wanna see more like this, you could consider subscribing. But yeah, thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.